I gracious to grant you the use of my chair? Aren't I wonderful when I give you a dead mouse? Aren't I utterly and totally beyond compare? And don't you admire the virtues you see in marvelous, lovely, magnificent me? I will carefully shed just selected dark hair when I'm lying on all the white laundry you did, and the white hairs will go when I bother to layer on black velvet where they can't be brushed off or hid. They look so much better that way, you'll agree. They'll remind you of lovely, magnificent me. If you try to insist that I live on dry food, I will either look thin and pathetic and sad, or I just might do something disgusting and rude, such as eat it, then throw up all over your pad. Only chicken and liver and fish naturally are fit for the palate of marvelous me. I really don't understand why you should look at anything else or have things in your hands. So I'll patiently lie on your papers or book to suggest that you treat me as my rank demands. You really should pet me when your hands are free. It's a privilege to fondle magnificent me. For just when you're maddest at something I've done, I'll go do something else that's so touching or sweet, that's so charming, adorable, silly, or fun. It'll just knock the stockings right off of your feet. Now you know you can't win, so why fight it? You see, I know you're a sucker for marvelous me. Sucker for my